Get your favorite t-shirt or download your new coloring sheet and sign up for our ad-free video streaming platform today at kidslearningtubeshop.com. And don't forget to subscribe.
Kids Learning Tube!
I'm Isaac Newton, I discovered the laws of gravity and motion. The three laws of motion that I'd like to teach you. You'll be surprised by how many that you already knew. It's a physics revolution. I was an English physicist and a mathematician. I lived from 1642 to 1727. I developed the theories of gravitation at 23 years old. In 1666, what an age to be bold. Though my laws may seem obvious to us today, over 3 centuries ago, they were considered revolutionary. The three laws are called Newton's three laws of motion. I'll explain all three with examples so you understand them with devotion. The law of inertia is the first law we will talk about. I'll explain what inertia means with an example, so check it out. Inertia's a body of matter that will stay at rest or in uniform motion in a straight line unless that state is changed by an external force. If this is hard to understand, there's an example in the next verse. Here we have a ball sitting completely still. It wants to remain that way, so it will resist with all its will. When an external force moves it in a direction, the ball will resist that force until it's motionless again. This applies with an object that's in uniform motion. It will continue moving until the external force causes commotion. Let's say a meteor is flying through the vacuum of space. It'll fly in the direction it was sent by the outside force that made it race. The meteor will continue forever in that direction until a different outside force makes any connection. That's Newton's first law of motion. The second law will come after you sing this chorus and it is done. I'm Isaac Newton, I discovered the laws of gravity and motion. The three laws of motion that I'd like to teach you. You'll be surprised by how many that you already knew. It's a physics revolution. The second law of motion, sometimes called the law of dynamics. We'll learn the second law now before your teacher gets frantic. The second law is a relationship between an object's mass, its acceleration, and the applied force is the last. If you want the mass of a football to accelerate, you need the force of the kick from your foot at a fast rate. But if the mass that you're moving is greater than the force applied, the acceleration will be less, but at least you try. Newton's third law of motion is a great attraction. For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. This is Newton's cradle. The mass in all these spheres are the same. To show an action with an equal and opposite reaction is my aim. When we let the first sphere go, it's mass times velocity barge. When it impacts the next sphere, the momentum transfer takes charge. Momentum's passed through the middle spheres and passed on to the final. Because the spheres have the same mass and their velocity is equal to the first sphere that impacted the middle three spheres. This is known as elastic collision. There's no loss in kinetic energy here. So for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. This Newton's cradle does define this action. I'm Isaac Newton, I discovered the laws of gravity and motion. The three laws of motion that I'd like to teach you. You'll be surprised by how many that you already knew. It's a physics revolution.
Kids learn it too.